preacher, when you want to preach, you can't preach anything. And this is the way it works with me. When I pray, I will wait on him. He may give you the first message. But when you respond to it, as I finish every evening, then the next thing will set into my spirit. I always know this is God. Sometimes when I was growing in this, I used to worry. When I'm involved in big conferences,
God
says, start with this. I say, what next? He says, start with this. Just follow me by faith. And he has never failed for one day. I want to tell you tonight, your life will become unlimited. To the extent you listen and you obey the voice of the Holy Spirit on the inside of you, he shall teach you all things. All things. And will cause you to excel in life. Then he said, and bring all things to your remembrance whatsoever I've said unto you. I want you to know tonight, brethren, it's a wonderful thing to be baptized with the Holy Ghost. We can go on and on and on and on. Without the Holy Spirit, without you responding to the Holy Spirit, you will live a defeated life. The Bible tells us in John chapter 16, verse 7, that when he comes, he will reprove the world of sin. Number 2, he will, in verse 8, of John chapter 16, he tells us that he will reprove the world of sin and then of righteousness and of judgment. Do you see how he testified to Christ there? He will show you that Christ is the end of the law, is the end of sin in your life. Of how you can receive pardon from sin. Then he will show you Christ is your righteousness by which you can live a holy life. Of judgment, because the prince of this world is judged. The Holy Spirit will unfail to you that Satan, demons, all demonic activities, they are under your feet. And let me tell you one thing. There is growth in revelation knowledge in those three areas. I cannot continue to explain that to you, but the Holy Spirit will take you there. I have grown in these three areas. You can know everything at once. It will reveal the secret of overcoming sin to you, that is through Christ. It will create in you the consciousness of righteousness that come through Christ. Then they will declare to you the prince of this world militating against people cannot control your life anymore. These are the things that will now lead you to miraculous. I repeat again, if you are not experiencing the supernatural, you are superficial as a Christian. If you are here tonight and you are not born again, Jesus is calling you now. Luke chapter 11, verse 11 tells us that how to receive the Holy Ghost baptism. That if somebody will ask his father, that is, there should be father-son relationship.
If you ask for bread, your father will not give you a stone. Bread is pointing to Christ. Christ is the bread of life. That's grace. Stone is the law. He will not give you law. Law was written on stone. Then how much more? You that are evil. If you know how to, with grace, give grace to your people, how much more will your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to them that ask Him?
First,
you have father son relationship, you become a child of God. Secondly, you ask. You know, in Christianity, I used to think that the emphasis is on asking. But I discovered in the context of grace, the emphasis is on receiving. Ask.
Bere.
You will receive. Receiving means there is something already waiting for you.
It's
provided already in grace. Already finished in Christ. The word they ask means make a demand on the right on what Jesus has already finished.
Bere fun eto re eyi ti Christi ti se pari.
He says seek,
o ni e wa kiri,
and you will find.
Eyin o si ri,
which means the Holy Spirit is a treasure, is already available.
O tumo si pe emi mimo isura ni o ti be ni sakani
re. When you seek it, the finding is the real thing, is grace.
O to ni wa ri yen o gan ni soju lowo re.
If you are seeking something that is not already available, you will not get it.
To ba wa nkan ti ko ti si ni pese o le ri.
So you have to recognize that this thing is already provided. It's set already for you by grace. It's a gift. Then he said, when you knock, the emphasis is not on knocking. The emphasis is like somebody behind that will welcome you and say, open the door and say, you are welcome. And that's the Holy Spirit. So when you are knocking, if there is nothing at the back, why are you knocking? You know, but you know nothing will happen. The fact tonight is that the Holy Spirit is waiting for you. Acts chapter 2, when I was reading it, it's so wonderful. They say the Holy Spirit came like a rushing mighty wind.
It's
rushing because it means that they have been waiting. As if, let me come in. It's more ready than you are. It's more ready to come into your house and lodge there.
Let you one walk
and you imagine the Holy Spirit rushing. I always think that he will be withdrawing from me.
No.
You know, there are many wrong theologies that we have that creates unbelief in our heart. Some people think you have to knock. That's not what the Bible is saying. You are getting it wrong. You see, the thing is already available, is by grace. One of the reasons why we find it difficult to operate the gifts of the Holy Spirit is that we don't understand it's by grace. You think that you must do certain things.
No.
Tonight, the Holy Spirit is on your side. The Holy Spirit is for you. Let's rise up and pray. I want you to begin to pray. Talk to the Lord and praise Him. praise him for this wonderful provision of Christ.
It's
the provision of Christ to empower us to go into the world, that you can have this permanent equipment
24/7
ministering to you as a student, ministering to you as a teacher, so that you can teach people the best way to teach. I want you to thank God for this great provision in Christ that can make you to excel in life as a medical doctor, as a mechanic, as an artisan, as a carpenter. I want you to thank God. You see, God has made it in such a way that we have an advantage over people that do not know the Lord. That when you are selling food in the town, people will say, "Now your food we want." It's because of the working of the Spirit of God. I want you to thank God for this advantage tonight. He will teach you all things. How to relate with elderly people. How to win favor before your lecturer. How to win favor with your neighbors. He will teach you soul winning. When to talk. How to talk. When to say it. I want you to know God. Our God is a wonderful God. But you need to be filled with the Holy Spirit. You need to be born again first. Then you come under for the baptism with the Holy Ghost. The baptism with the Holy Ghost is for sons. People that have son father relationship with God. Father son relationship with our heavenly Father. And I want you to know, if you are not yet born again, you can do so tonight. You can come under the cross. You can come under the blood. The blood of Jesus will make you whiter than snow. The grace of God will come and live in your heart. Christianity is very, very real. You know where I was working before? God has brought me to become acting director. The moment I was promoted to that position, just within 2 minutes, he told me to leave. You know, the Holy Spirit will teach you all things. If I have not followed him, I will not be doing what I am doing today. You cannot be using your peanut brain. You have to listen to him for you to excel. I want you to begin to ask God tonight that the Lord will take you over completely in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, righteous Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Before we pray for Holy Ghost baptism, those of you that want to be born again, I want to pray with you. You are not sure of your salvation. You go to the church. You fast. You pray. You dance. You pay your tithes. But deep down in your heart, you have not been born again. You don't have the assurance. You fast, but you are not sure. You can be sure tonight. It's only Jesus who saves. And I want to lead you to salvation. Those of you that want to be born again, let me see your hands up. Raise up your hand where you are and wave it to me like this. Wave it to Jesus right now. You are going to be saved tonight. Then you will receive the Holy Ghost baptism at the same time. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Spirit of God will come upon you. And you will be speaking in a new tongue. This is very, very important. Anywhere I go, any conference I do, I have been mandated that this Salvation and Holy Ghost baptism is very, very critical.
Ati kan ni dada fun mi pe oro igbala ati baptism ti emi mimo igbodo mo se ni.
Because this is, you cannot run the Christian life in the flesh.
Nitori pe irin ajo igbagbo o le gbe ninu eran ara.
But the Holy Spirit working in you.
Emi mimo lo gbodo mo si se ninu.
Those of you that are raising up your hand.
Gbogbo eyin te ti gbe owo
ni want to be saved tonight, you want to be baptized at the same time.
O fe ni igbala lale iko si gbagbara emi mimo.
I want you to come forward now.
Tete
rush forward because our time is up. Come forward, let me pray with you. Before we pray for Holy Ghost baptism, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, come forward. I want you to run. Run to this place now. Our time is gone. We want to close early today. In the name of the Lord Jesus, you want to be born again. You want to give your heart to Christ. And at the same time, you want to receive Holy Ghost baptism. You can be baptized with the Holy Ghost and be born again at the same time. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I want you to know tonight is the final night. It will be terrible to leave this ground without being born again. This is a great opportunity for you. If you don't respond to the truth of the word of God because of pride, you will fall into the hands of false prophets later on. I want you to rush forward to come and give your heart to Christ tonight. And at the same time, we are going to receive the Holy Ghost baptism in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Those of you that are in the front, put your hand upon your chest. If you don't run and we finish, people are still rushing from the back. Rush, come. Come here, we will soon pray for Holy Ghost baptism. God loves you so much. The day I got baptized with the Holy Ghost, my life changed radically. My understanding of the Bible, everything changed. Up till today, I am growing in it. I can stay on my Bible from morning till evening. Oftentimes, I even forget food. Because the Bible becomes sweet like honey. Thank you, Jesus. Put your hand upon your chest and repeat this prayer after me. People are still coming at the back. Let's come, let's run. If you are coming to Christ, come. People are still coming from this side. God bless you. Let's rush forward quickly. This is a day you will never forget. Heaven is rejoicing over you. Close your eyes and repeat this prayer after me. My Father and my God, I thank you for the great love you have for me. Thank you for your death for me on the cross of Calvary. Thank you for taking my place. Thank you because my sin was imputed to you. My judgment was imputed to you. The condemnation for my sin was imputed to you. I believe this with all my heart. Father, tonight, I give you my heart. Wash me with the blood of Jesus Christ.
Fi eje Jesu Christi for me.
Let your spirit come to live on the inside of me.
Je ki emi re wa ma gbe ninu aye mi.
I want to be born again.
Mo fe di atunbi.
I receive your righteousness by faith. In the name of the Lord Jesus. I receive your cleansing by faith. In the name of Jesus Christ. I receive Christ as my Savior by faith. In the name of Jesus Christ. I receive Jesus as my Lord by faith. Fill me now with your spirit. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, for saving me. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. Thank you for saving me now. I am saved by the grace of God. I
pori ofe Olorun.
I am washed in the blood of the Lord Jesus.
Ati fi eje Oluwa Jesu for me.
In Jesus name I pray.
Loruko Jesu ni mo gbadura.
Amen.
Amen.
No matter what you possess or the position you occupy in this life, if you don't have Christ, the Bible says that you are poor, wretched, blind, miserable, and naked. You cannot enjoy God in this world or live with Him in eternity. Neither can your good works or religion save you. My friend, you need to accept and believe what Jesus Christ has done for you on the cross. If you are ready to do that right now, put your right hand upon your chest and say this prayer from your heart with me. I thank you, Lord Jesus, for taking my place and dying for my sins on the cross. Today, I accept you into my heart as my personal Lord and Savior. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for accepting me. Thank you for receiving me into your kingdom. Thank you for saving my soul. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.